Alright dudes, it's the end of wet placer season. Got a beautiful day, sun shining, the water's thawed, we're gonna do a cleanup. And today's gonna be a good one. Let's see some gold. And as you can see, here's my nifty new sluice extension. Carpet, miner's moss, expanded metal, a little catch. We got our bucket flare with some matting in there. And three stack cube. More aggressive on the bottom, regular up top. And this is gonna be a killer setup. The whole reason I built that secondary sluice for the bottom of the cube is to catch more concentrates. For my black sand smelting test, I'm gonna make an extra sluice to go on the end of my gold cube to capture more heavy so I have more concentrate for the smelt. I'm gonna make use of this folded aluminum box I got here. I'm gonna use this medium size expanded metal, lay some miner's moss in the bottom of the box, and clamp down the expanded over top the moss. With this setup, I should catch more fines, a heck of a lot more black sand, hopefully non-magnetic black sand, sulfides, and those sorts of things. Perfect. All right, well, I'm trying to rig this up with just scraps I got laying around. I got this steel bar. I can use that to distribute the weight, hold the riffles down. I'm gonna give it a bend back here. Bend up here. You can see we got a nice bow. So when I push it down, it should push all the riffles down evenly. So that'll spring out over time, but if I clamp it down here in the middle, just like that, and it's gonna hold the expanded metal riffles down perfectly. So I'm liking this a lot. All right, well, I think I figured it out. So we're gonna leave the expanded back here. We got a little bit of exposed miner's moss. I'm gonna leave it just like that. I got this piece of rubber here that has a little flap. I think I'm gonna glue that in here. And that way the miner's moss can hold under the flap. We'll have a little bit of a moss semi-slick plate into expanded metal. I think this will be a pretty good secondary sluice to capture more fines. I like it. Position just right, and that's gonna work. It's gonna work like a charm. I'm gonna do a fire assay on the non-magnetic black sands to see if we got any silver, platinum, and or gold values. And I want as many cons as I can get so we can get a bigger sample to assay. All right, we're back and dialed in again. Now is bonanza time. I'm gonna break this up into two runs of about 100 pounds of black sands each, just so we don't overwhelm the system. I want to get the best recovery of gold I can. And also by doing two cleanouts, I'm gonna end up with double the amount of cons and hopefully double the amount of non-magnetic black sands that we can do a fire assay on. We're gonna see if this river's black sands are worth anything. Seen gold already, first scoop. Oh yeah, some nice flakes. Gold, gold. Each scoop has a good amount of gold in it, so I think our top tray of the cube here is going to be glowing with gold. Now that's pretty interesting. None of the black sand has made it down to the bottom sluice yet. Look at that. It's just barely starting to trickle down now because the system up top is overwhelmed. I don't know if we got a funny feed, but it's all coming down this side, so I'm going to level this out so we get an even flow. Shoot, so we've already hit solid ice. The second bucket is also ice, right there. There's a big old ice ball, look at that. It's about cantaloupe size, maybe a little bit bigger. Buckets are finally thawed, on to round two. All right, we're still down here by the river. It's getting dark and cold, but we're almost done. So I know you guys are gonna ask, these are the non-magnetic cons from the secondary sluice below the gold cube. So this is what the cube and dream mat missed. Right there's a nice, decent sized, flat, really thin flake of gold. Here's another flake of gold. And then these white things are really thin pieces of lead. So that's all lead that went through the system. Those, that guy right there, this piece here in the middle, but otherwise, pretty good recovery. Really, there's no point in having sluices below the cube the way I have it set up now, besides the fact that I wanted more non-magnetic sands. And here I got my non-magnetic black sands that we're gonna smelt tomorrow, do an assay on. It's a beautiful evening out here at base camp. It's actually darker than it looks. Alright, here's one pan of non-magnetics. You can see it's kind of purplish red. It's a whole lot of garnet sands in there as well. Here we have our furnace propped up. We're gonna put this big old steel pan on top so we can dry out and roast these concentrates. So we're gonna add these to the pan. We're gonna fire it up and get it roasting. I used started burning and we got a thin layer of steel that came off, so I removed these little flakes out of the concentrates here, but we still have a little bit. You can see that shiny baked onto the steel, and I can't get it off without taking the metal with it, so we're just gonna leave that there. Mix up the cons with the flux. Ooh, look at that. So it did turn a little bit more red, but a lot of the red that we see is garnet sand, and I do see a fair bit of gold in there. Ooh, schnitz. Wasn't thinking. So for this go around, I'm gonna drop the collector metal in the bottom, pour the mix in. Centered. Close the choke. Light her up. So I'm gonna heat this smelt up really slowly. I want to make sure we don't have a boil over. more semi-cooled. Let's see if we can dump it. Nope. Most part. Button's still stuck in the bottom. The slag looks pretty glassy and stony, so I think we got a pretty good smelt on it. All right, now let's see if we can get this button out. There she be. There's our button. This part's still holding on, so we might have a mat layer on here. And it does look like a lot more stony, so that probably is a mat layer right there. We're gonna clean the slag off this, get it loaded in the coupelle in the furnace, and coupelle it down. Way hot. There goes the lid. Right. More force will do it. Centered. Nope. I think next go around I'm gonna put some mold release on it. Maybe some oil, WD-40. I don't know, I'm gonna have to research a little bit. There's most of it. Still got our button in the bottom. Let's take a look at the slag. Real clean, nice and glassy. All right, give it a good one. Nothing. Well, you can see the button down there in the bottom. It just doesn't want to come out. Finally, took some coercing with the sledgehammer. We got the lead button out. Pretty much intact. which is pretty surprising and amazing. There it is. We're gonna clean it up and load it up into the furnace. Is here's the bead. I'll give my opinions on if this was worth doing or not here in just a bit. This is the bead from the first black sand smelt, 33.5 grains, just over 2 grams. There it is. We're gonna have to label these results as invalid because I had too much visible gold in there. I can't accurately determine how much more I recovered that was not visible. This is our precious metal bead from smelt number 2, black sands location number 2, 3.3 grains. Now in this sample I panned out a majority of the visible gold. I can attribute roughly 1 to 1.5 grains worth of gold that I could still see. So we at the very least recovered 1.5 grains extra gold. Now at 3.3 grams, this is roughly our cost to smelt and coupel the black sands.